Hi there. Well, we're here at Capitol Plaza, and Brian Doobie has just walked into the room standing next to me. Brian, tell me how you're feeling. You've been watching these results tonight.
I want to go ahead and go here, see if we can get a crunch here for you. If you could hear that, Mary, that is the layer of ice over the road.
Now, I want to give you an idea of where this is. If you look over my shoulder here, you're looking at the Given building. It's a glass building just in front of Fletcher Allen Medical Center.
If that happens, people within a half mile of this train yard can expect to get a call from 911 that will tell them to leave the area. They can go to St. Albans Town Educational Center to warm up if they need to.
The bishop did issue an apology today in this multi-million dollar settlement.
Newspaper headlines like this one about Pat O'Hagan have become a part of life for people in Sheffield. And even before police identified her body, everyone we talked to had already feared the worst.
Here's the FDA's two cents. It says all natural is hard to define because most foods are processed in some way.
Well, as we said, Jason Gibbs there conceding the Secretary of State's spot. He said this was close, but it just wasn't enough. Live in Montpelier, Jill Glavan, News Channel 5.
Coming home on the airplane, you'll be here in a little bit.
Waiting and explaining why is a lot of what Desiree Burke has spent the last year doing with her 2.5-year-old son, Tyler.
Soon, very soon.
Monday, she, Tyler, and her in-laws waited just one last moment.
Can you see him? Look where they are.
Straining for a glimpse of Tyler's dad.
There he is Alaska. He's right there.
There he is.
He's right there.
And finally, a reunion.
Surreal, a relief, excitement.
Tyler, you got really big.
The last time Captain Tyler Burke saw his son, he was barely forming words.
Picked him up and all of a sudden he started talking to me, sentences, and that was very different.
For his mom, Deb, it's a time to capture, but this moment is actually bittersweet.
Son Bob's a Blackhawk pilot and he's in Iraq.
You see, Tyler may be home, but his brother just left. Part of a Blackhawk team that deployed to Iraq in September. For Deb, it's a mix of emotions.
You don't know what's going on. You know, the communication is better, but it's not like you can pick up the phone and talk to him.
But for one son's return, at least, there's a lot to catch up on.
It was just wonderful seeing him again. His smile, it's just like my son's.
In South Burlington, Jill Glavan, News Channel 5. When you're grocery shopping,
I seldom read the ingredient labels.
There's a lot to look at.
Maybe I'll look at like the nutrition facts, but never like the ingredients.
A lot to choose from. A lot of ingredients.
Ingredients. Cream.
Cream, water.
Eggs.
Sweet flour.
Skim milk. Sugar.
Sugar.
More sugar.
Sodium bicarbonate.
Okay, maltodextrin.
Xanthan gum.
Carrageenan. Carrageenan.
Something all these items have in common.
All natural.
100% natural.
But are they? It's carrageenan, by the way.
Carrageenan.
Carrageenan is kind of a thickening agent for ice cream.
Meat doctor.
Mingrua Guo.
Ingredient deciphering expert.
Natural white meat, chicken, carrots, noodle.
We gave him three all natural products.
Natural sea salt, onions.
Campbell's garlic. Select Harvest Soup.
Maltodextrin. Only thing that bothers me here is the maltodextrin.
Log cabin syrup.
I have a little bit of trouble to see it is natural. The citric acid definitely is not natural.
And Ben and Jerry's ice cream.
Wow, there's so many ingredients. Cream, skim milk, liquid sugar. We don't know.
Dr. Guo's diagnosis, liquid sugar looks suspect, but Ben and Jerry's says it's just water and sugar. Easier to mix that way. As for the others.
I like this better. This probably not that much.
So why be concerned? Turns out that all natural label doesn't actually mean anything.
Anybody can put the word natural on a product.
Hi, I'm Lisa Goslin. I'm the editorial director for the Eating Well Media Group.
The people at Eating Well hear a lot about all natural.
We increasingly are getting questions about labels. What does this mean? What does that mean?
Here's the FDA's two cents. It says all natural is hard to define because most foods are processed in some way. If you want to put the word natural on a label, the FDA says just leave a few things out. Added color, artificial flavors, synthetic substances.
What I think we've seen in recent years is a big backlash against foods that we don't understand.
But what about the products that are using the labeling correctly?
This is just regular creamy. My name is Chris Kaiser. I'm the president of the Vermont Peanut Butter Company.
Kaiser makes 100% natural peanut butter.
This is just organic peanuts and a little low-sodium sea salt.
How does he define natural?
100% natural to me, and I believe probably most consumers, is that there's nothing in there that's artificially made.
Sounds easy enough, but we've learned. The best way to know is to learn your ingredients, even if they're hard to pronounce.
Soy lecithin.
Lecithin.
Soy lecithin. Carrot
bicarbonate.
These boxes are Sam Bromley's delivery for the day. It's his mode of delivery that might turn heads on a day like this one.
I don't think I'm crazy, but I enjoy the fact that I get to be outside.
Bromley rides for One Revolution, a Burlington-based bike delivery company. Make that year-round bike delivery.
It would take a lot for us to not be out.
From the middle of the street to the sidewalk less traveled, a little snow is hardly cause for a day off. Much like the lot at Capital Lincoln Mercury, where it's all hands on deck.
Parts, service, sales, management, everyone is out.
You thought your car was a pain to clean? Try hundreds of them.
A snowstorm like this, 4 to 6 inches, is a full day.
Some clean up for business. Others just to get out of the driveway.
I thought it was a little deeper than I thought, so out came the power tools.
Either way, call it clean up part one. Don't expect that snowblower to get much of a break.